In a previous video, I told you I will show you the right way to brush your teeth, or what you should do in order to prepare your teeth, in order to brush them. So I just finished eating and now I should brush my teeth. But before I brush my teeth, I have to make sure that the pH of the saliva in my mouth is alkaline, because if pH of your saliva is acidic, then you scratch your teeth and you damage your teeth instead of helping them if you brush your teeth. So in order to make sure that the pH of my saliva is alkaline, there are two things I can do. Number one, and the easiest, is to rinse my mouth with coconut oil. But when you rinse your mouth with coconut oil, it is important to take a very small amount of coconut oil, like 1 teaspoon, small teaspoon, and to rinse it in your mouth and to keep it in your mouth as long as it feels comfortable, or as long as there isn't too much liquid in your mouth, because when you rinse, you don't want to breathe small particle of oil, so that oil reaches your lungs, because that's why some people got lung cancer, because they used to rinse with coconut oil and they inhaled small particles of oil. So you don't want to do that, and that's why you have to keep the coconut oil for small amounts of time. And when your mouth creates too much saliva, you spit and you take another teaspoon. So you may take 10 teaspoons of coconut oil, okay? It doesn't matter how often you change the coconut oil. What's important is that you do not inhale the coconut oil. Teaspoon. And when you feel that your mouth gets full, you spit it out, and then you take another teaspoon. And when your mouth gets full, you spit it out. That's the first option. So this is how I increase the pH of the saliva in my mouth. But if you don't have coconut oil, or you don't want to use coconut oil for some reason, you may use miswak powder or siwak powder. Miswak powder increases the pH of the saliva in your mouth. You just take a bottle, add some alcohol, 70% alcohol in it, and add miswak powder inside. So this is what I have in here. Alcohol with miswak powder. You place a little bit of this mixture in another bottle with some water. Okay, and here I have a little bit of this mixture with water, where I also added hydrogen peroxide, because 1% hydrogen peroxide kills bacteria. You may use hydrogen peroxide or you may not, it's up to you. This mixture, water with miswak and alcohol, kills some bacteria and it increases the pH of your saliva. And rinse your mouth and spit. And now you make the toothpaste. So you may use all the ingredients that I've posted where I showed you how to make the toothpaste, or if you're in a hurry or you don't have all the ingredients, it is extremely important to use enzymes. If you have cavities, you should get papaya enzymes or papain. Make sure you place some papain in your toothpaste. This is the most important ingredient if you have cavities. Now, if you do not have cavities, but you just want to regenerate your teeth, then you should get BFC powder with comfrey. Actually, comfrey regenerates bones. I fixed 3 fractures with comfrey about 20 years ago. So I do recommend comfrey. And this form, it's easier to use. This is a must because it has some ingredients that have a natural form of calcium. So if you don't want to use calcium hydroxyapatite healthy calcium, if you don't want to use bentonite, then I do recommend buying this. This has natural form of calcium and it has comfrey. So if you want to make your toothpaste really simple and easy, just mix papain enzyme with BFC and comfrey, and that's it. Iodine, because most people are actually deficient in iodine nowadays, and that's why their bones break, because they're deficient in iodine. Well, because they're deficient in iodine, they have problems with their thyroid gland, and the thyroid gland, when it's messed up, it messes up all the other glands, and removes calcium. So you definitely want iodine. Here I'll also add some coconut oil. And now, because I spent a little bit of time with the miswak in my mouth and with the coconut oil in my mouth, saliva in my mouth is alkaline, so now I can brush my teeth. So this is the toothpaste. Oops. And I will go and brush my teeth now. So I finished brushing my teeth, and now I will use this to rinse my mouth. Okay. I keep my toothbrush in a glass with alcohol in it because I've noticed my toothbrush is cleaner this way. Most people say you should keep your toothbrush outside so that it dries out, so that bacteria don't multiply inside it. But I've noticed it's not true. I mean, my teeth feel cleaner and fresher since I started keeping the toothbrush inside alcohol. This is 70% alcohol. And yes, I change it every week, or when it evaporates, or when it feels like there isn't enough alcohol inside it, I just throw it away. And I get new alcohol in there. And I do not rinse the toothbrush before I use it. I only wash it after I use it. And I place it in here. And I store it in here. And that's it. This is my ritual for brushing my teeth. Bye-bye.